If you follow the news, you have probably heard about the coronavirus outbreak in China.
Airports around the world are installing thermal cameras to screen for people with elevated body temperatures.
If you would like to find out how this technology works, stay tuned. I'm Marcus Terran from movitherm Advanced Thermography Solutions, and in this video, I will explain how to use a thermal imaging camera to detect people with an elevated body temperature. I will show you how a thermal camera works, how to measure skin temperature, and what you can and cannot detect with this technology. Please make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel, click the bell icon, and leave your questions and comments below. And with this, let's get right to it. So, how does a thermal camera work? To explain this better, we have set up a little experiment here. So we have a couple of coffee mugs. One contains hot water, one contains cold water, and we have a FLIR thermal camera on the other side pointed at those coffee mugs. What we see here is the thermal camera image coming from the software running on a PC that we cannot see in the scene right now. And on the left side, we have an orange glow, which indicates hot temperature. And on the right side, we can barely make out the cold cup. And we have drawn a couple of regions of interest around these cups. And we can see here on the software, it actually measures the maximum temperature from the hot cup to be about 170 degrees Fahrenheit. And on the cold side, we see about 63. So now that we understand how a thermal camera works, let's see how we can apply this to measuring skin temperature. When the immune system detects an infection, it usually kicks into high gear and raises the core body temperature. Based on recent research, the best location in the face to detect the core body temperature is the inner tear duct. However, one problem that occurs is when somebody wears glasses, because the thermal camera cannot see through glass, so the glasses occlude the important temperature locations in the face. Another important fact to point out is that the thermal camera cannot detect a particular virus. It can merely tell you whether you have an elevated body temperature. For that to work well, you need a very high resolution thermal image across somebody's face. We have seen examples where thermal cameras are just pointed at a large crowd. This will not provide enough resolution over the tear ducts for an exact body temperature measurement. If you like this video, please make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and leave your questions and comments below.